a single man. I look for three things in a girl: beauty, intelligence, and she has to find me funny. All right, with a key on the third one. Because my last girlfriend, or as I like to call her, the Xbox, she was not a fan of my sense of humor. A lot of stuff about her I wasn't real crazy over. She was very noisy all the time and bulimic. Yeah, I was always going, honey, keep it down. And it just got old. You're a smart crowd. That joke isn't designed to get a big laugh. It's basically an IQ test rolled up into an awful pun that I slipped you. And your, oh, is enough to let me know that you have your wits about you. And I appreciate that. She was an idiot. She was. Knowledge is key. And she was locked the hell out. It was painful. I couldn't take it. We were watching Dr. Dolittle Part 2. 3/4 of the way into the film, there's a scene where Eddie Murphy's getting sued, so his wife in the flick's gonna be his lawyer. She looks at me and goes, oh my God, you gotta be kidding me. They would never let your spouse represent you in a court of law. This movie is ridiculous. And I'm like, there have been animals talking. I don't know if you saw that part. It was like the whole time. She was a stripper that loved to play Monopoly and couldn't figure out why I called her community chest. Do you understand what I had to put up with? How about the day I was on my computer eating powdered donuts? She thought someone put anthrax in her email. I mean, you guys have no idea how long of a 6 days that was for me. But she'd never leave. I tell you what, though. Her biggest downfall, she didn't have a filter between her mind and her mouth. If something showed up here, immediately, she said it. We were in an elevator. We had 8 or 9 floors to go. Someone gets on, they're only going up one floor. I don't say anything. She goes, man, it sure is sad how lazy some people are these days, isn't it, honey? I'm like, not today, seriously. She's like, come on, Josh, it's one floor. I'm like, the guy's in a wheelchair. Would you shut up? He's got feelings. Only from the waist up. And I was like, you know what? No. Okay, no. I cannot believe that I just wrote that and pretended my girlfriend said it. That is just unacceptable. Being single can be good for you. It forced me to become domesticated, which I'm proud of. I mean, I know how to cook and clean and iron. There are a lot of things I've given up on and realized I'll never be able to do, like folding a fitted sheet. Good luck with that, dude. That is witchcraft. I'm serious. Because, you know, I'm pretty good about figuring stuff like that out. And for a long time, I would pull it out of the dryer with the hope that that's the day I crack the fitted sheet code. I Googled it. I printed off an illustrated step-by-step diagram. It was like you make a fist and then you put all four corners on, lining up the seams inside your forearm. It doesn't work. All right, don't even bother. The only thing that works is to roll it into a ball and put it in the closet until you're ready to use it. And I know people from Kentucky are like, why do you have more than one? Listen, I am not, don't, look, I'm not trying to make anybody feel silly. Listen, the problem with the roll-up method, for me personally, it doesn't work. Because every week I'm in a different hotel, I have to walk past housekeeping carts and see them laying there perfectly folded. You sons of bitches. I don't think you know what that feels like to have someone stare at you for yelling at a maid cart in an empty hallway. But they don't see that it eats at your soul. 6 days of every week, I am reminded of a task I can't do. And the worst part of that is, I have no idea how I'm ever going to get over it, other than, of course, meeting a woman who knows how to fold a fitted sheet. But I don't speak Spanish, you know, so, like, that's not going to happen. You know, it'd just be the same argument every week. Rosa, no say! Just a joke, people, just a joke. Let's, just kidding. It probably will get me stabbed after a show one day, but until then, it's hilarioso. So, keep that in mind. It's important. Ladies, is a sense of humor important in a man? Does that matter if he can make you laugh or not? Yes. Whatever. Listen, you say it. You all say it. I read it in Maxim every month. Beautiful celebrity laying there scantily clad. What do you look for in a guy, Scarlett Johansson? He could be fat and stupid and poor, but as long as he makes me laugh. Tell you right now, being funny never helped me get the first date. I've tried. I tried to use my sense of humor to impress a girl. Always backfires. January of 05. I will never forget this day as long as I live. I'm walking through a mall. There's a girl in front of Victoria's Secret. She stops me as I'm walking by. She's like, "Excuse me, sir, are you shopping for a wife or girlfriend today?" I was like, "No, why?" She goes, "Because we're having an after Christmas sale and all our bras are 50% off." To which I replied, "I like when your bras are 100% off, right?" I mean, that quick. I was proud as could be. I'm not gonna lie to you people. I thought I hit a home run. Not because it's that funny, but the timing was impeccable. And she didn't even get it. Didn't get it. She's like, 100%, that's stupid. Okay, because then they'd be free. And I'm like, well, that's one way of putting it. You know, at that point, actually, they would be free. Which just got her even more confused. She's like, "Hang on a second. Becky? Becky!" I'm just going to run this by my manager because I'm a little confused right now. I just started. Maybe there's a deal I don't know about where you get one. But okay, here she comes. "Becky, this guy says he thinks our bras should be 100% off." And the other girl's like, "Really? Then we wouldn't make any money." And I'm like, "Well, I think you're wrong there, too." I beg to differ. And she's like, "What's differ?" And I was like, "What?" She's like, "I don't know, you said you beg for it." I was like, "What the hell is wrong with you two? I'm funny. I thought that's what you wanted, you know? I mean, I could have been in the gym working out, but I was writing jokes, and now look. I mean, it's not fair." And I went on about my day, feeling great about myself. You know why? No, I didn't get a date with that girl, but I had a great story to tell. And that's what I encourage each and every one of you to do in your life. Do it for the story. Doesn't matter what it is. Meet that person from the internet. Hook up with that comedian who's only in town for a couple days. It doesn't matter. Give it 110% and you're going to have a tale to tell. I always do it for the story.